As many Filipinos begin their Holy Week exodus, Teddy Locsin Jr. reflects on the Gospels, on the life of Christ, and their historical importance. Here's tonight's Teditorial.
The events commemorated this week are not mere religion, they are not myth or legend. They are historical, and as likely to have happened as anything we can be sure of in recorded history. The Gospels are historical coverage of the triumphant reception of Jesus in Jerusalem and his shameful rejection by the same, of his passion, death, and resurrection, written from four different angles, but with utmost fidelity to personal recollection and unchanging oral tradition. Oral tradition never adds more details when the raw facts alone are already too much to keep in mind. The Gospels are written down, if not by direct witnesses like John, from the fresh recollections of witnesses still living who would challenge any mistakes in the oral tradition. One gospel may give more details about an incident than the others, but the same one may emphasize one detail at the sacrifice of another mentioned in the other gospels. None contradicts the others, but together corroborate what even the apostles wanted forgotten. Their cowardice when Jesus was arrested, the treachery of one of them for 30 ringgits, silver, their pettiness in seeing waste instead of prophecy in a woman's act of rubbing Jesus' feet with an expensive ointment reserved for the noble dead. Not least their cheap ambition, jockeying for cabinet positions in a passing kingdom of today, instead of the kingdom of heaven and earth the day after tomorrow. We believe everything we know of the war between Athens and Sparta from the account of one man who fought on the Athenian side, but whose sympathy lay with the Spartans, and of the Arab revolt in the desert from a tormented colonel. Our sharpest images of the Boer War come from the self-conceited memoirs of a spoiled but talented brat, young Churchill. Yet we believe. Here is history from four different angles, written when living contradiction was a distinct possibility, and the danger of writing down increased with the intolerance of the enemies of this faith. Believe it. The closest thing to the Gospels in fidelity, though not truth, might be the instantaneous one-liners on Twitter. Keep well.